Are you running away with it? That's cheating. Hello, my name is Kait, and welcome to Habits of a Modern Hippie. You might notice that we are in a little different location today. That is because this video might get a little messy. So, in front of us, you'll see some of my grocery shopping from this week that I did at supermarkets and farmers markets. I'll insert a clip of my fridge here. All right. So, this is what my fridge looks like right now. Are you so excited? No? Are you? Say woo. No woos? Oh, you'll woo. Woo? And we're gonna pull some of this out and see what they can have and what they can't. So fun. But essentially, what we are going to do is kind of do a what my dog can and cannot eat from the groceries that I got this week, and share that with you, what's safe and what's not safe. And this is not an exhaustive list in any way, shape, or form. There are lots of different fruits and veggies that pups can eat and can't eat and all of that. This is literally just what it was in my fridge and on my counter and what they can and cannot do. And for this taste test and kind of explanation of yes and no, there's going to be a yes pile, a eh pile, and a absolutely not pile. And we will share those. If you want to get a little bit more in depth, I also did a blog post about this on my website. So I will insert that link down below. So you can click over to that if you want to see more of like what toxins are in things, sugar content, things like that when it comes to whether or not produce is safe for your puppies. Are you girls ready? Do we want to try some food? And because we're on the floor, you are ready. This might be a little bit interesting trying to figure out the dog situation, but I'm just gonna insert here. If you haven't subscribed already, go ahead and hit that down below because I'm pretty sure the girls will be very excited. Can you hit the subscribe button? Yay! You do, Miss Ting. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so we're gonna start with the ones on the floor first because I don't want these silly little fluffs to accidentally knock over mason jars of water. So this first one, this is kale, purple kale. I actually really like this. I know a lot of people do not like kale, but what do you girls think? You can't have it. So kale is the first on our no-no list. Kale actually contains a compound called calcium oxalate, and that can cause kidney stones and digestive problems in dogs. So kale is a no-go. Okay, next we have spinach. Spinach is in my category. So dogs, totally safe for them to have it. You just don't want them to have a lot. It's the same reason I don't like to give a lot of spinach to my chickens. It contains a compound that actually doesn't allow for calcium absorption in the body. And when that happens, it can affect things like the liver and gallbladder and stuff like that. So kale, yes, but I wouldn't say that that's okay. So we can give them a little piece. A little bit is not going to do any issues. But what do you think? Do you want to try some spinach? That would be a no. How about Miko? Next. Next is this jar. I'm going to find one of the other pieces of produce in this bag because they go together. Miko, you gotta come back here. Miko keeps going for the water. Okay, so chives, onion, you can also put in garlic and leek in this family, but they're all part of the allium family. Allium family, super toxic to dogs, especially toxic to cats. So no onions, no chives, none of that. We want alive puppies. This one can be really bad. Okay, and the last one that is out of the bag. Yes, this is watermelon. Yes, both dogs
absolutely love it. This is super safe for your pups. It's actually really hydrating as well. Just take out the seeds, don't let them eat the rind, but you will be good to go. So we are gonna get a little bit messy and push this forward. And would you like some watermelon? I'm not giving you the whole piece, Miss Tank. You gotta bite it off. You go. You can't steal it either. Good job. You want some more? Here, let me break off a piece, okay? Isn't that better? What about you? All right, we are getting into my basket now. My basket is actually a handmade one from when I lived in Barcelona, and it is my favorite thing to bring to the farmer's market. So we'll just go in and pull stuff out. Dun, da, da, dun. This first one, these are plums. Plums are amazing. They are on the list. Essentially, plums, if you take out the pit, they're fine for dogs, but they're also really high in sugar content. So if you have an overweight dog, or if you have like a smaller dog and one of these accidentally gets into them, not the best idea. You guys have to back up. I'm using a knife. Ah, 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 ah. So if you, I'm gonna sheath this every time so the dogs don't get into it. But if they get the fleshy part, that's okay. No. Here you go, Meeks. You wanna try this? You gonna eat it up? Plums were a no-go. Wait, did you eat yours? Do you want this? You can have Amico's too. Oh. Apparently Tinkerbell is okay with a plum. That was yummy. I love them too. Next we have a peach. Palisade peaches. I live here in Colorado and Palisade peaches are some of the best. You also know they're really good when they just rip open. I'm just gonna get this juice everywhere. Okay, we're gonna use a knife and maybe not let it drip all over the place. Ah! Now leave the knife alone. All right. Peaches, totally good. Just don't feed them the pit. A lot of times when you hear, like, don't feed them either pits or seeds, it's because they either contain cyanide or arsenic in them. Neither one. So Tinkerbell apparently is a fruit girl. And Miko is not having this. All right. Next, we have cantaloupe. I can't really tell it's cantaloupe because I've already taken it out. This is my stasher bag. I have quite a few of them. They're amazing if you don't have them already. Essentially, they're reusable silicone bags. But this has cantaloupe in it, and cantaloupe is totally fine for your pups. So let's pull out a little bit. Do you want some? Yeah? That was good. You want some? Miko is not a sweet pup. You don't like that. Okay. So, next, we have mushrooms. My mushrooms are in a mason jar. Whenever you store mushrooms, you just want to make sure that the top of whatever it is open. But mushrooms, not good for pups. There are a bazillion different types of mushrooms, and I'm sure you could, like, get away with, like, the white button mushrooms that you get in the store, but I just wouldn't risk it. So no go on the mushrooms. Next, we have cucumbers, once again, in a stasher bag. If you guys are interested in these, I'll put, like, links to them in the description. But cucumbers, once again, good for puppies. So, should we try them out? great for their skin, super hydrating, etc.
Want to try a cuke? You gonna eat it? No. How about Miko? You gonna eat this? No? Why are you being so picky, little miss? Okay. Oh, hi.
All right, next we have corn. This is also on my list because while the corn kernels can be really great for your pup, if they get into the corn cob, it can cause blockages in their intestinal system and all of that, so that's not a good thing. But we'll see if they might like a few kernels.
All right, you want to try some corn? No, you don't think so? Okay. How about you, Miss Miko? Do you want to try some? You don't want to try anything today. You gotta at least put it in your mouth. Thank you. You're just getting them all over the place, all over the floor, all over my legs. You still have dirt on your nose, little messy. There's literally just kernels on the floor.
All right, next on my list is tomatoes. Tomatoes, when they're green, contain something called solanine, which is also toxic to dogs. And so you can get away with it, but it's not something that I think you should. Okay. Next, we have radishes, and radishes are actually okay for dogs. However, radishes are spicy a little bit for humans, not like hot spicy, but like they can have a little tang to them. So, how did I lose my knife? Where'd it go? Oh, here it is. So we will cut off a little bit and see if the pups might want to try a little bit of radish. I love the smell of radishes. They're so good. I have this pickled radish recipe that is phenomenal and just makes me really.
Thanks. You can be first this time. Will you at least put it in your mouth? Put it in. That is cheating. All right. Try biting it. You gonna try them down there? You got it open. No, you don't want to? All right. Hi, you're very cute, but you girls have been very picky today.
Okay, so next on the no-go list, are you sighing because you want the carrots that are in the bottom? You silly geese. So avocados are a no-go. The seed, the pit, the leaves all contain a toxic substance to dogs called persin. And the flesh doesn't contain it in as high amounts, but also not good. So no avocados for puppies, just for me. Just for me. Next is one of their favorites. And this will truly test on whether or not they're just being silly and picky today. But green beans that are in this little jar, they are good for puppies. And usually they will eat them. Yeah. That's what I thought.
Are you running away with it? That's cheating. You like them too.
Next we have squash in another one of my little reusable bags, which I love. This is zucchini. Zucchini is perfectly safe for dogs, and squash in general is pretty good, especially if you have an overweight dog. Butternut squash can be really nice, like roasted and nothing on it, but sorry, I just smacked you in the face. but roasted and put into like kibble and whatnot.
Do you want to try some?
Okay. Just a little bit. You have to back away from the knife though. Sit down. Good girl. Sit down. You wait for it. And all of the food that's like going onto the floor or into the dog's mouths, it'll go, all go out to the chicken, so none of this is gonna be wasted.
What do you think about squash? You gotta stop licking stuff. You gotta bite it. Bite it. How about you? Immediate no.
Oh, I found another little allium family in the bottom of the bin. So this is a no. This one, oh my gosh, my brain just turned off. This is a, starts with an S, shallot. There we go. Oh my goodness. I swear, I have been up since way too early this morning. So shallots, also toxic to dogs. And the last two in here, they are good for dogs. So we have celery. And celery is good for pups, very high in water content. One of the things when it comes to celery, just because I'm an overprotective mom, all of these little strings that can get like caught in throats and whatnot make me nervous. So I just break the celery and then pull them off. So they still get most of the celery. The rest of the celery will go into my compost. And then the dogs get celery.
Miko, you can't walk away with it. That's not allowed.
Here you go. Tinkerbell's never been a celery fan. Miko loves it though.
And then last but not least, if you guys have been around for a long time, you know how much my dogs love carrots. Miko, do you want a carrot? As soon as she heard the word carrot, they are back. So I know that they are gonna run away with these, so we will end here. So thank you guys so much for watching. Once again, if you wanna know a little bit more about why they can and cannot have these foods, I'm linking that blog post down below. If you liked this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button down below. Means a lot for us. Hey. Excuse me, can you at least get your butt out of the camera? Let me sit down. So we will see you guys again soon. Girls, can you say goodbye? Say goodbye. No, don't smack me. Say goodbye. Say goodbye. Say a woo. That was a baby woo. Good girl. Woo. Good girls. They love carrots. Obviously carrots are safe. They're also really good for their teeth. Bye.